We have 180 seats here. You know, there's no tablecloths. We've tried to make it as comfortable as possible. You could come here and have all vegetables, not really know it, and be very satisfied. And that's including the pizza. You know, you just don't even know that you've not had any protein. I guess about 4 years ago, I started going to LA quite a bit. I really like the food in LA. I think that it's a lot lighter, you know, not much cream or butter. We want to come up with a really kind of light direction, all based on sharing, incorporating pizza. I've always loved pizza. We've probably tried 20 different recipes. Like, I didn't know about number one or two or three flour, only knew about double O's. I think it adds a little bit more flavor to the dough. We have here distinct seasons. We have rain and we have sunshine. The labor is also very good. I care, obviously, about all the cooks that I've worked in any of my kitchens. I want them to do really well. You have our apple salad there with toasted walnut, Szechuan pepper, Aveline cheddar, and a lemon vinaigrette. These apples have just come in. If it's come from Whistler Pemmican or Fraser Valley or the Okanagan, it just does taste a little bit better. Then you've got our house-made sausage there. The beef sausage with chanterelle mushrooms, a beer mustard. We make all the sausages in-house. Our cauliflower here with harissa. We go through an enormous amount of cauliflower. It's a great food cost too. The octopus, we're going through about 100 pounds a day. There's a lot of nervous octopus out there. The traditional Mexican way, it's blanched 3 times, load of citrus, olive oil, some aromatics, and then a low heat. Let's go a whole bunch of liquid. We take that out, let it cool, and then we cut them into their pieces. 5 years ago, we opened up Hawksworth. Hawksworth is a contemporary Canadian modern take on things. It's 90 seats, about 26 seats in the bar. And then we have upstairs the York Room, which is about 60 people up there. And so the hotel was totally run down. When we started building this, I was standing on basically rubble. The only thing that they really kept were the floors. You know, everything here is 100% brand new. It's structured like a traditional European kitchen. There's a pass, there's 2 chefs that work the pass, they plate all the food. Everybody else just pushes the food forward. We're open breakfast, lunch, and dinner. We're 7 days a week. We're voted number 2 in Canada. What we want to keep here is that it's very light. We want a very fresh feeling. I don't want people to like, oh, I can't eat anymore. We don't serve bread here unless it's asked for. When you buy it, it's $4, right? So just try to keep room for dessert. This dish here we've had for quite a while, hamachi, which is farmed. It's nice and fresh. The bar, we have lots of really unique spirits over there.
We've rooted our cocktail program in the classics, partly because of the identity of the hotel, but also because it's the best way to introduce novice cocktail drinkers to cocktails. We've amassed a series of bottles of interesting spirits that I've allocated from around Europe mostly. So essentially it's time travel. You're literally drinking a Manhattan that they would have been drinking in 1920. You're drinking rarity. We can't go to the store when we're done our 1921 bottle of Canadian Club whiskey and buy another one. But that bottle of whiskey was in the barrel in 1950, World War I whiskey, and that would have been the exact same whiskey that would have been smuggled from Ontario to Chicago during Prohibition.